Synchrogalactic Yoga is a system of inner discovery and self-research that unites traditional yoga practices with the synchronic order. The system of Synchrogalactic Yoga provides the template or matrix for realizing the supermental human within ourselves. True knowledge is based on experience of both the external and internal worlds. It is easy to concentrate on sensory objects as the mind naturally goes outward. It is the inner concentration that we are concerned with. The external world is merely the projection of the inner or subtle worlds. The external world is the effect. The internal world is the cause. The power of mind is unlimited. The system of yoga equips us with the means of observing and interacting with inner states of consciousness, primarily by learning how to concentrate, operate, and focus the mind. The practice of Synchrogalactic Yoga helps us purify our mind and transmute our psychophysical structure by changing the vibration of our thought cells so that we become a medium of transformation, embodying a superconscious level of reality. Synchrogalactic Yoga is most closely aligned with Jhana, Raja, and Kundalini Yoga. In this chapter, we will focus on the system of Synchrogalactic Yoga, which is followed by the practices in the next chapter. The entry point to Synchrogalactic Yoga is through the seven chakras. When we awaken our chakras, our mind and consciousness go through systematic changes, heightening our perceptions, releasing blocked energies, strengthening our magnetic field, and tuning us into higher frequencies. Before we begin the practices, let's review some basic tenets of Kundalini Yoga. Kundalini Yoga is part of the tantric system that focuses on expanding and broadening consciousness by releasing concentrated forces within the physical body. Through yogic practice, the body relaxes and consciousness is released into a liberating force that unlocks the dormant powers of the mind. The spinal column is the capacitor of the internalized electromagnetic field, with a positive and negative terminal. The nadis are the channels that carry pranic energies to and from the spinal column or central channel. Ayurveda mentions 72,000 nadis. The law of time teaches that the 72,000 nadis are on either side of the body for a total of 144,000. The sense organs and chakras operate by three main nadis, Ida, Pingala, and Sushumna, that begin at the Muladhara or root chakra. The system of Kundalini Yoga tells us that those who are able to master the nadis enter the highest states of consciousness and attain full command of their bodies and minds, thereby attracting the power of the siddhis, perfections. Vital energy is channeled through the chakras or wheels, the psychophysical centers that are aligned at the central channel, Sushumna. Sushumna is the passage through the center of the spinal column. In most people, this passage is closed. Through yogic practice, we can open this channel and reach states of continuing and superconscious. Chakras are strung along the Sushumna channel in the form of lotuses and or wheels. These chakras begin at the base of the spine with the root, then the secret center, then the solar plexus, then the heart, then the throat, then the third eye, and the crown. Around the chakras are two other channels, the solar channel, Pingala, right, and the lunar channel, Ida, left. Pingala conducts life force and Ida conducts consciousness. These two channels feed the two hemispheres of the brain, which control all bodily systems. Ida and Pingala function according to natural cycles by the law of alternation. However, at this time these flows are disrupted in most humans due to living in an artificial civilization out of harmony with nature and natural time. The imbalance of these two flows manifests as the mental and physical imbalances that we see in the world today. The purpose of yoga and breath control is to balance these energies by consciously realigning them with the cycles of nature. Like the two strands of DNA, the Ida and Pingala alternate from right to left of the Sushumna at each succeeding chakra, until they meet at the third eye, where they unite and form a subtle knot. My lineage is the union of intrinsic awareness and the ultimate sphere. This is the affirmation for radial plasma gamma, located in the third eye or Ajna chakra. From the third eye, the Ida and Pingala channels then terminate in the left and right nostrils, while the Sushumna continues upward to the crown chakra. Only when the Ida and Pingala come into proper balance does the Sushumna channel awaken from the root to the crown. Within the Sushumna Nadi is the Brahma Nadi, or the void channel that connects the Brahmarandra, a cavity between the two hemispheres of the brain, the corpus callosum, located in the crown chakra, Sahasrara. This is precisely the location of the holomind perceiver, the newly evolved sense organ. The system of Kundalini Yoga utilizes channels called nadis to activate different energies. Ida, Pingala and Sushumna are the three main nadis in yogic tradition. Nadi comes from the Sanskrit word meaning movement. In the Rig Veda, the most ancient Hindu scripture, the word nadi means stream. When harmony is attained between these two, then the third nadi, Sushumna, is awakened. Through yoga practice and control of the breath, the nadis, the streams that carry vital energies, are purified and disciplined, leading the mind to expanded awareness. According to the law of time, there are two primary circuits of consciousness that serve as cosmic memory templates: the Aboriginal Continuity, AC, and the Cosmic Awareness, CA circuits. These two circuits process information that can be activated through yogic practices and are essential to understanding the system of Synchrogalactic Yoga. The Aboriginal Continuity Current contains the primary codes of enlightened conduct. It also corresponds to innate psycho-mental forms, internal sensations, and the sense organs themselves. The AC represents information flow from future to present. It weaves the original matrix from which history arises. Cosmic awareness accounts for history and represents analytical methods, articulating specific action modes built upon models of past acquired behavior and knowledge. The CA contains the cumulative cultural forms and eventually the civilizational sense fields, inclusive of the planetary environment. The CA currents represent the formation flow from past to present. While AC is intuitive, innate knowledge, CA is learned, acquired knowledge, which ultimately expands into a state of pure cosmic awareness. However, This cosmic awareness has been covered over by artificial time and replaced by civilizational advance, manifesting as worldly power and acquisition, with the highest priority given to technological advancement and the proliferation of materialist values and belief systems. The sum effect of the AC and CA deviation from the biosphere norm is twofold. The crystallization of artificial construct ultimately undermines biological functions and aborts instinctual intelligence from becoming intelligently conscious. This results in a simultaneous condition of sensory overload and sensory deprivation within the individual organism of the deviant species as a whole. Like the Ida and Pingala, the AC-CA currents form the root of the DNA double helix pattern, spinning up through the central column of the etheric body. Currently, the AC is separated from the CA function. This separation is exacerbated by living in artificial time apart from nature's cycles. It is the purpose of the law of time to re-establish balance between the AC and CA currents through methods of yoga. The AC-CA structure holds together the two sides of the galactic brain, or galactic field of intelligence, holonomically registered as the noosphere. It also constitutes the regulating mechanism of the psi bank, which constitutes the noosphere as a supermental organism. This will be further elucidated in Chapter 6, Holographic Yoga, and also the appendix, Galactic I Ching. In Synchrogalactic Yoga, the conscious movement of breath into the body is directed toward and correlated with the spine and central nervous system. The spine column consists of 33 divisions or 33 esoteric joints that can also be allocated with the 7 chakras. According to cosmic science, there are 33 secret chambers in the Great Pyramid of Ra in Egypt, 3 of which contain information about cosmic science: 5th chamber, 11th chamber, and 13th chamber. 33 is the number of the initiate. It is recommended to begin Synchrogalactic Yoga with a complementary practice of Hatha Yoga, Asana and Pranayams. The word Hatha has 2 syllables, Ha, sun, and Da, moon. Bodily postures combined with deep rhythmic breathing help us to release physic and psychic blockages, while at the same time cultivating a flexible biohomeostasis, bringing different aspects of ourselves into greater cosmic alignment. We want to create a fluid continuum, where exertion and discipline of body and mind become one fluid, seamless whole. Pranayams, or correct breathing, calms the thought currents, relaxes our body, and opens us into higher forms of meditation. Our rate of breath is inseparable from our state of mind. If we want to calm our mind, then we first slow our breath. The mind follows the breath, and the body follows the mind. Along with asanas and pranayams, a vegetarian diet high in plant foods is strongly recommended not only for the body, but for the planet. Find a program that works for you when cultivating the body-mind. Asanas, mudras, pranayams, martial arts, dancing, etc. Cleansing and fasting for the mental-emotional body. Meditation, visualization, artistic impressions, and or telepathic exercise for the mental body. In Kundalini Yoga, the main key is to balance the Ida and Pingala channels so that the life force can rise from root to crown unimpeded by obstacles. The law of time introduces a new stage of evolution, hyperorganic evolution. This refers to the ability of the human to utilize the sense organs as points of energy emission and consciousness. This means that the sense organs get telepathically extended outward, which results in natural phenomena such as clairvoyance and clairaudience. Within the body, the AC and CA currents are etherically aligned with the Ida and Pingala currents. The function of the AC-CA currents is dependent on the activation of the chakra generators and radial plasmas. The chakras are energy vortices within the body that can be thought of as transmutation chambers. They are conductors of electromagnetic energy and control centers for the transformation of etheric and subtle energies. Energy from higher or subtle dimension is brought into the physical dimension through these seven energy vortices. Through the chakras, physical energy can also be transmuted into higher forms or stages of consciousness, such as continuing and superconscious. The chakras, as psychic centers, are psychoactive energy generators fed by streams of prana. Prana is the life force energies, both of the physical and astral worlds. Within the prana lies the seven radial plasmas, each with its own qualities and powers. Once consciously breathed in, these plasmas may be directed to different chakras where they provide the energetic psychotelepathic fuel. Each of the seven centers is a receiver for one each of the seven radial plasmas. The first step in Synchrogalactic Yoga is to activate each of the chakras, making them powerful, purified receivers and transmitters of cosmic energy. We want to raise each chakra from the level of unconscious to conscious, continuing conscious and superconscious levels of operation through a consistent series of practices and meditations. We first awaken these chakras within ourselves and then transfer our consciousness into awakening the chakras of the earth. The chakras can be thought of as switches that we turn on. When we switch them on, then the light streams in, purifying our perceptions and thinking. When the chakras inside the planet are switched on, then shadows dissolve and a new world is revealed. See Chapter 6, Holographic Yoga. The five principal chakras are root, solar plexus, heart, throat, and crown. These focus on the integration of the three bodies: Nirmanakaya, physical third dimensional body; Sambhogakaya, radiant soul essence, fourth dimensional body; and Dharmakaya, electronic higher self, fifth dimensional body. The two minor chakras, secret center and third eye, focalize on transcendental functions of being. The third eye is associated with inner vision, intuition and wisdom, and the secret center is associated with sex and life force or kundalini. These two minor chakras are connected by the kundalini third eye wisdom channel, capacitates paranormal powers. The unification of these two chakras holds the purposive function of sex as an evolutionary process. Above and below the seven chakras, we introduce two new chakras: the root of root, earth core, and crown of crown, noosphere. These are planetary centers of cosmic information, transmission reception, noosphere, and reception transmission, earth core. Through these two new chakras, we extend our intelligence circuits through the solar planetary intelligence dynamic. This encompasses the entire orbital system governed by the Sun, known as the interplanetary solar noosphere. The three bodies, physical, emotional, and mental, are suspended on the axis of the chakra system. The root main chakras govern from the bottom of the physical body, root, to the top of the mental body, crown. The center of mental body is the third eye, and the center of physical body is the secret center. The center of the emotional body is the heart, that extends to the throat chakra for its expressive ability, and to the solar plexus chakra, where emotional energy is received and transmitted. After opening the chakras comes the activation of the radial plasmas for constructing the inner temple or etheric body. The radial plasmas are micro-quantaelectrical charges, each with unique characteristics. The seven plasmas create the primary micro-quanta electric building blocks of universal structures, such as atoms. With their capacity for instantaneous transmission, radial plasmas also function as storage units, information banks, and telepathic message units. In their conductivity and instantaneous information-bearing capacity, the radial plasmas occur naturally throughout the universe. Prana is the cosmic energy that sustains all life. It is defined by cosmic science as electric vitico quanta of the type chemio, as an existential biological quanta. Chemio is one of the six types of electricities in the cosmos and relates to static distension. Quanta refers to the minimal logical detectable quality of energy of space-time. In other words, prana is a type of dynamic cosmic electricity that establishes the electronic charges that give life, both to the physical and astral worlds. Chemio is combined with the electricity type kum, static, makes up kappa, one of the 12 electronic lines of force. The electronic lines of force are the sub-sub-subatomic electrical flows or partons. These 12 types of electricity flow through everything in the universe, causing all atoms, molecules, planetary bodies and stellar bodies to be in a continuous spinning motion. Kappa doubled creates radial plasma kali. See Cosmic History Chronicles Volume 2. Plasmas are the constituent components of prana or chi. According to cosmic science, activation of this prana or dynamic electricity calms down the processes of karyosynthesis, aging, and mitosis, cell splitting. In order to delay the process of karyosynthesis, it is recommended to walk with naked feet early in the morning so that the vrittis, etheric sole of feet, have direct contact with the earth. Prana from the earth enters through the vrittis, which serves as receivers and transmitters of fastenic lines of force that feed the chakras. Fastenic lines of force is what generates the auric field. If one meditates afterwards, the results are even better. Regular massage of Khan Vrittis, palms, is also recommended. Prana is a function of the holonomic feedback system of the generation and recirculation of cosmic electricity. First, the raw plasmic pranic energy is breathed in and absorbed by the chakras as plasmic psychoelectric generators. The chakras then transmute the radial plasmas into fastenic lines of force utilizing double parton sequences. Prana is a function of a holonomic feedback system of the generation and recirculation of cosmic electricity. First, the raw plasmic pranic energy is breathed in and absorbed by the chakras as plasmic psychoelectronic generators. The chakras then transmute the radial plasmas into fastenic lines of force, utilizing double parton sequences. These fastenic lines of force are then secreted by the body to create the aura. The more consciously this process is participated in, the stronger and more spectral the aura will become, and the more it will attract high vibration, plasma and prana. See Cosmic History Chronicles Volume 2. The air that we breathe is filled with prana. When prana is deeply inhaled, it charges all the etheric bodies, creating a feeling of lightness and weightlessness within the physical body. The ultimate goal of activating the chakras and radial plasmas is to purify and synchronize the electromagnetic field of the human brain with the electromagnetic field of the Earth. The purposes of Synchrogalactic Yoga is to lift the lower mind into higher wisdom, realization of the supermental superhuman. To purify the physical emotional body by learning to attune to pure being, 5D entity. To imprint radial patterns in order to grasp different levels of information simultaneously. To engrave new planetary programs that are beneficial to all. To attain cellular transmutation into a body of radiance, leading to systematic states of superconsciousness. To coordinate the third dimensional being with the fourth dimensional being, the physical body with the etheric body. The etheric body is the mantle or vehicle of the soul. To become integral chips or units who create the foundation of the next stage of evolution, planetary solar consciousness. Note that Synchrogalactic Yoga also incorporates a set of mudras, mantras and mandala. Mudras are gestures that create a sense of one's own being, as an instrument or vehicle of cosmic forces or energies that take particular forms and give particular cosmic sense of ritual, turning body gesture into symbolic language. Mantra focuses on primordial sound vibration. The primary dimension of universal coordination. The universe is made of sound, or different musical notes, tones, and resonances. Some forms of yoga are sound yoga, sabda yoga, which is an offshoot of the Sikh religion. This focuses on liberating the mind by tuning into the inner cosmic sound. Anyone can hear this. There is vast and subtle texture of sound that can be heard when the mind is empty. The seven solar mantras attune the biopsychic apparatus to the solar frequencies of the coming solar age. Chanting the seven solar mantras opens the seven solar gates. Solar yoga was first brought through in the modern age by Yogacharya Janakiraman. When you chant these syllables, listen to the sound while visualizing the different chakras and plasmas. These can be chanted from the bottom moving upward, in a clear, strong voice. Mantra means mind protecting, and when recited, purifies the mind of lesser thoughts. This is a powerful experience to practice the mantras and engineer your own auditory matrix and system of cosmic sounds. Mandalas or yantras, the visual sound, are forms that help concentrate the mind. Mandalas represent symbolic or integrated geometric structures focused into different forms. The geometry of the universe is condensed into different mandalas or yantras, and you learn to identify your body and mind with these different structures. This is the visual part. Before any practice, it is suggested to memorize the symbol and functions of both the traditional chakras and the radial plasmas. You can practice drawing and coloring the symbols as shown in the diagram, and meditating on each of the symbols until you become familiar with them. The radial plasmas can be envisioned as the motor within each of the chakras. The radial plasmas are made of heat, light, electronic partons, and electronic lines of force. Altogether, the plasmas establish two hyperquanta, sensory, Daliceli gamma, and telepathic, alpha limi and cilio. The following are a set of practices to increase focus and concentration in order to penetrate into higher realms. You can begin practice immediately. The best time to practice is before sunrise or in the evening around sunset. It is recommended to practice one exercise a day, according to the daily radial plasma. Before practicing, read through all of the practices so that you have a whole vision of the system. We will work on four levels. 1. Traditional chakras. 2. Radial plasmas. 3. Mind-soul spheres. And 4. Heptad gates. Keep in mind that every form, sound, and color has a different frequency. When these frequencies are overlaid, then we have the experience of synesthesia. This is the future of yogic activity. In brief, the nature and purpose of these four levels is as follows. The first level, meditating the chakras, is a basic introductory level that serves as a bridge to the new practices. Meditating on traditional forms of the seven chakras transforms consciousness by inwardly awakening the etheric psychic centers. Here we also introduce two new chakras, root of root and crown of crown. The second level, activating the radial plasmas, awakens the seven electronic lines of force, both in our body and on the planet. Plasmas are electronically charged subatomic particles that saturate the universe with electricity, electrical flows, electromagnetic fields, and radial lines of force. The purpose of this practice is to learn how to direct plasma, cultivate our electromagnetic field, and recognize ourselves and the planet as a purely electronic entity. This will help us to develop higher mind control. The third level, engaging the mental spheres, familiarizes us with the 6+1 mental spheres of consciousness as introduced in Chapter 3. Through this practice, we habituate ourselves to the different states and capacities of mind that the soul journeys through. The soul, mind, and consciousness are part of one continuum, each with different levels and functions. Study of the 6+1 mental spheres teaches us about the nature of mind as it relates to the interactive telepathic fields of the universe. The fourth level, opening the Heptad gates, is an advanced level that integrates the first three levels and introduces us to the seven solar mantras and the seven gates of the holomind perceiver, the basis of the 441 matrix practice. This level is also meant to introduce us to the system of synchronotron, the yoga of unification of the higher mind with the science of time as practiced by the star masters. It is the yoga of the nine stargates of Sirius. This will be further elucidated in Cosmic History Chronicles Volume 7, Book of the Cube.